Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today we are starting by looking at the SpaceX fans website with an upcoming Starlink launch which was delayed from this week. Starlink 22 is now scheduled to lift off on Wednesday, March 24th at 8:58am UTC or 4:58am EDT. Gavin Cornwall posted a tweet with some information about the SpaceX fairing catcher boats, Miss Tree and Miss Chief. He said, Ghost Searcher and Navigator have been reconfigured back to Dragon Recovery today. Miss Tree and Miss Chief are out of service, no fairing recovery. An interesting ship, Shelia Borderland, is arriving at Canaveral tonight. 250 foot long, big crane, hot pink. An unusual sight, coincidence maybe? Gavin also posted some other shots about this new recovery ship. He said some glam shots of the Shelia Borderland, SpaceX's new recovery ship. 250 foot long, 50 ton crane, 60 berths, 20 knots top speed, built 2015. Pink stripe in support of the fight against breast cancer. In addition, Kyle Montgomery posted some shots of this new ship too. He said, Shelia Borderland has a crane on the back and will possibly replace Miss Tree and Miss Chief for fairing recovery. Looks like they have begun testing or practicing because there is a fairing half on deck. There is a new NASA article about a joint agreement signed by both NASA and SpaceX. The article says the focus of the agreement is on conjunction avoidance and launch collision avoidance between NASA spacecraft and the large constellation of SpaceX Starlink satellites as well as related rideshare missions. A conjunction is defined as a close approach between two objects in space, usually at very high speed. SpaceX are continuing the construction of the orbital launch pad tank farm. More concrete work is being done at the launch site. A new bridge crane to be installed inside the top of the high bay was delivered. Tankzilla was extended to help with the stacking of Super Heavy BN1. Here's a view of the latest work on the interesting new structure in the production yard. There was a fire in one of the tents recently. There was an animation posted of a specialized propellant tanker idea designed to just store cryogenic liquid. Musk was asked, could this be useful in the long run? He responded with, an orbital propellant depot optimized for cryogenic storage probably makes sense long term. There's a new ring stack with lead-ins outside waiting for a nose cone. Here's the nose cone that will probably be stacked with it. This nose cone has also now received a flap. A new ring stack was spotted on a mount outside the high bay. The GSE-1 tank was stacked on top of that ring stack we just saw, I believe. With no flight during the week, SN11 is still waiting for another static fire attempt and possible launch this coming week. Looking at the Cameron County website, they've posted a bunch of road and beach closures for this coming week. There is a closure scheduled tomorrow, possibly for another static fire attempt as well as a possible closure on Tuesday. There's then another closure scheduled for Wednesday 24th with a possible closure on Thursday as well. So hopefully next week we'll see another static fire attempt as well as a launch. The FAA also posted a new temporary flight restriction for the possible SN11 flight this coming week. This TFR is for Tuesday 23rd, so depending on the outcome of the static fire, we could see a flight as soon as Tuesday for the SN11 prototype. On Thursday, SpaceX stacked the two pieces to form the very first Super Heavy booster, what a beauty. Musk posted an incredible shot on Twitter of the first Super Heavy booster in the process of stacking. In response to that tweet, somebody said, you gotta hoist a Starship serial number with a crane above BN1 just so that we can see what a full stack Starship looks like. Elon Musk responded with, we will need a launch tower for that. Hook height for the lift is approximately 140 meters and both booster and ship need to be stabilized at stage separation joint. Everyday Astronaut asked Musk about this booster saying, what's the plan for this particular one, Pathfinder? Incredible to see the world's most powerful rocket coming to life. Musk said, yes, Booster 1 is a production pathfinder figuring out how to build and transport 70 meter tall stage, Booster 2 will fly. Marcus House retweeted Super Heavy with the caption, this is why they need that bridge crane. Temporary solution, chop a hole in the top of the high bay for the crane, a very SpaceX-ish fix to the problem. Musk said, the reach around. Thanks to Brendan Lewis again, we have the latest Starship and Super Heavy prototype build status. Super Heavy booster number 1 is now stacked and SN11 is waiting to fly, with SN15 hopefully not too far behind. As always, I have to thank Mary, known as Boca Chica Girl, who is out there all day every day filming the amazing content. Also, I didn't thank Jack Beyer in my last video, but thanks to him as well, as he's been out there a lot recently filming the Boca Chica stuff too. Plus, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working hard behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.